душою, your nationality, душою. You are black people, you are the sons and the daughters of God. You are you mocking on the hearing.
Yeah.
On this street and wake up his people.
That's right.
1/3 of the people gonna make it. 2/3 of y'all gonna be put to death. Y'all ain't never walking charcoal.
That's right.
Daddy, you wanna talk about study to show thyself approved? No, brother, you study to show yourself approved and understand that you're an Israelite and not a so-called Negro or African American.
You only have I known of all the families of the earth.
That's right.
Most of Daddy only knows you blacks and Hispanics.
That's right.
The world of Israel.
That's right.
You blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans. It's high time you wake out of sleep, man. Voice.
like a trumpet and show my people their transgressions.
To show you, black sisters and brothers, utilize your transgression. What is transgression? What is transgressions, brothers and sisters? Statistically, they say blacks and Latinos are number one in being religious.
Don't.
Number one in being religious. What do transgression mean? Transgression means sin. The Most High God told us, commanded us to come out here and reveal the sins that's in you, brothers and sisters. Come and read again. Let's finish those verses. Get into it.
Isaiah chapter 58, verse 1. Cry aloud, spare not. Lift up thy voice like a trumpet, and show my people their transgression, and the house of Jacob their sins.
Black man and black woman don't know they're the house of Jacob. The Hispanic man and woman don't know that they're the house of Jacob. But we are here to reveal it to you.
That's right.
You are the 12 tribes of Israel.
That's right.
That's who you are. That's who you be. Jump to Deuteronomy real quick. We are commanded to come out here and show our people their sins. And we gotta be courteous and start off with our sisters. You black sisters, you Hispanic sisters, you Native Indian sisters. Do y'all know according to the Bible it's a sin to abhor? Have you ever heard that before? Sisters, have you heard that in church that it's a sin to abhor? Sisters, have you ever heard that before?
Y'all ain't got no.
Have you ever heard T.D. Jakes preach that to y'all? Buffalo. Did he tell y'all it's a sin? Let me prove it to you. Come and read it.
Deuteronomy chapter 22, verse 5. The woman shall.
You are a woman, right? Women, right? So let's establish what we put a read is pertaining to the woman, the black woman, the Hispanic woman, the Native Indian woman, the Israelite woman.
That's right.
The woman shall not wear.
Shall not. Shall not. What shall the woman not wear?
That which pertaineth unto a man.
Read that again.
The woman shall not wear that which pertaineth unto a man.
So we read in Exodus 20 that thou shalt not kill, thou shalt not commit adultery, and the Lord said thou shalt not wear that which pertaineth to a man. And I know we have not learned this. So what do women wear that pertaining to a man, brothers?
What is it?
Pants, right? What else? Is it just pants? What else? What else do a woman have on that a man would wear?
If you say another word, God will strike.
Come on, brothers and sisters. What is it? Pants? Tight spandex, shorts, boxers, anything that a man wear, you're supposed to be wearing, sisters. Why? Because you don't know that you are royalty. You don't know who you are. What you do every day, did y'all know we learned this during slavery?
That's right.
Have y'all forgot about slavery? Have you blacks and Latinos forgot about slavery? Call it again.
Deuteronomy chapter 22, verse 5. The woman shall not wear that which pertaineth unto a man.
So sisters, this is godly correction. If you sincerely love God or Jesus Christ, you'll keep this commandment. So let's see what we're going to say about the man, because we are in ATL.
Neither shall a man put on a woman's garment.
Come and read this verse again. Because we are in ATL. And y'all are known for many things in the earth today.
What's the commandment?
Yeah. Atlanta is known for a lot of various things. Let's hone in on one specific thing. Let's go.
Deuteronomy chapter 22, verse 5. Uh-huh. The woman shall not wear that which pertaineth unto a man.
Go ahead.
Neither shall a man put on a woman's garment.
Is that going on down in Atlanta? Do we have brothers down there dressing like women?
Yes, sir.
Are they wearing thongs? Are they wearing bras? Are they wearing high heels?
Are you wearing?
Are they not wearing lipstick?
Your mama wearing lipstick.
Huh?
Your mama wear pants.
So what are we all gonna show you that you are the Israelites? You brothers and sisters realize y'all have customs. Y'all have ways that y'all have not learned in America. Hold that. Get off there, 46. I'm seeing brothers destroyed and this place. And don't even know why.
Go and read that.
Hosea chapter 4, verse 6. Once again, we are reading out of the Holy Bible. We are in the book of Hosea, chapter 4, verse 6. Read. My people are destroyed. Once again, God said, who? My people. Y'all do not know that y'all are the people of God.
That's right.
Religion has taught you this Bible is for everybody. But when you read the Bible, this Bible is talking about you, sisters. It's talking about you, brother. It's talking about blacks and Hispanics. Y'all never heard that before, right, y'all? They didn't tell y'all this on BET. Y'all didn't hear about this on 106 and Park? Come on, read again. Hosea chapter 4, verse 6. My people are destroyed for lack of knowledge.
God says that the black man and black woman, Hispanic man or woman, is destroyed because they lack his knowledge. Read Malachi 2 and 7. What is the knowledge that the black man is lacking? What is the knowledge that the black woman is lacking? Y'all, some of y'all got your 8th grade on diploma, high school on diploma, GED. Is that the knowledge that God said that's lacking in our people? Let's read what the knowledge is according to the scriptures. Read.
Malachi chapter 2, verse 7.
Read.
For the priest's lips should keep knowledge.
What's that knowledge?
And they should seek the law.
Seek the what?
The law.
The what?
The law.
The law. Y'all ain't never heard that in church.
That's right.
Y'all preachers don't teach y'all no laws. Look at y'all out here today. We looking at the lack of laws being taught to the children of Israel. Look at our sisters. No respect. Look at our brothers. Look at our people strung out on drugs. They effeminizing our young men. Y'all don't see this? Is this how we are? Go and read it again.
Malachi chapter 2, verse 7.
Uh-huh.
For the priest's lips should keep knowledge.
Read.
And they should seek the law at his mouth.
You'll never hear this in church. Because the Christian church today ain't set up teaching no laws.
That's right.
The Catholic church today ain't set up teaching no laws. The Muslim mosque ain't set up teaching no laws. It's to keep you deluded. Give me back that Hosea 4 and 6.
Hosea chapter 4, verse 6. My people are destroyed for lack of knowledge.
God acknowledged that the black man is destroyed. The black woman is destroyed. And y'all don't see it.
Yeah.
Y'all think y'all supposed to turn up. Y'all think y'all supposed to dress like video vixens. That looking effeminate is called swag today. Look at the dudes, look who y'all listen to. Chief Keef, 2 Chainz, Lil Boosie, Gucci. Losers, Kanye West, losers, Jay-Z, losers. What have they added to y'all? What have the Great Blueprint album added to you, brothers? You sisters. What did Beyonce add to you, sisters? She yelled about being independent, and y'all, and she got a husband and a child, and y'all see him. Come and read again.
Hosea chapter 4, verse 6. My people are destroyed for lack of knowledge.
What are we out here teaching is that you black men, you black women, you Latino men and women, you are the Israelites the Bible speaks of.
That's right.
You are royalty.
That's right.
You are the sons and daughters of God, but that sounds too good to a simple Negro. They love being niggas. They love cooning. They love being a royal star. They like the world seeing you as nothing. Go and read it one more time.
Hosea chapter 4, verse 6. My people are destroyed for lack of knowledge because they have has rejected knowledge.
What is a black man doing?
Rejected knowledge.
What is a black woman doing?
Rejected knowledge.
This is how we know y'all been destroyed in slavery. The Most High sending brothers out here that look just like you, stay in the same communities like you. And what happened? We don't get no respect out here. We get the jokes, the meme mugs, the FUs, the checks in there dancing and cooning, and folks laughing. We're on the bottom of society, and we still cooning.
That's
brother,
right.
Don't get on the bus and train, still cooning. Don't own nothing, ain't looking to own nothing.
That's right.
Read the Hosea 4, 6 again.
Hosea chapter 4, verse 6. My people are
God said his people, which are you blacks and Latinos. Y'all didn't know that though. Read.
Are destroyed.
Y'all destroyed out here in Atlanta. Look at your sisters and brothers.
Look at you. And it's funny. You get an audience. Y'all laugh. And then when your children die, y'all want some sympathy. When your house is burning up, a tsunami comes through here, and then you yelling for help.
That's right.
Y'all destroyed or don't even know it. Breathe.
For lack of knowledge.
Because y'all lack God's laws. That's what you lack. Women out of order, men out of order, whole community out of order, race out of order. Read.
Because thou hast rejected knowledge.
We out here giving you the knowledge. We don't be out here for hours giving our people knowledge. But let's see this how people gonna take it. Let's see this how people gonna take it. Read.
I will also reject thee, that thou shalt be no priest to me.
You reject God's knowledge. The Lord gonna deal with you differently here in this place. This might be your only opportunity here in this today, brothers, sisters. Y'all think y'all might make it home tonight. It's not promised to you. You think you're finna go catch the bus and turn up tonight to party. It's not promised to you. The Most High don't own nobody up and down the streets. No. This is your opportunity to wake up. Once again, we are teaching you who you are. That you are the Israelites according to the Holy Bible. We are the Israelites according to the Bible. If you got questions, come forth. We are here to help you. Go and read again.
Proverbs chapter 1, verse 20.
Read.
Wisdom crieth without.
Wisdom is crying out in this corner. Read.
She uttereth her voice in the streets.
God said that his wisdom was going to be out in the streets. Not in no church. Y'all have never heard that before, right? Well, you hearing it now. Read.
She crieth in the chief places of concourse.
And it's not this a chief place of concourse? Is this not where you blacks are at, congregating, chilling, enjoying the day? God said that his wisdom was going to be right here. Read.
In the openings of the gates, in the city.
In the what?
In the city.
That's where we at, read.
She uttered her word saying.
So now we're going to find out what is wisdom going to be crying out here on this corner. Is we gonna be telling you to hold hands with everybody and sing in Jubilee? Is we gonna teach you to break God's laws? To go to church? Worship white Jesus? No, we're gonna teach you what this wisdom is, read.
How long, ye simple ones, will ye love simplicity?
I want you to read that again nice and slow. Because the Most High God is saying something to you brothers and sisters.
How long?
God is asking you, how long, brother? The question's posed to you. Only you can answer that. How long? How long, black brothers? How long, sisters? How long you done been in this lower state?
That's right.
Not giving a damn about nothing, living like nothing and loving it.
That's right.
Read.
How long, ye simple ones, will ye love?
Will you what?
Will ye love?
Our people love what?
Simplicity.
Y'all love this simple life.
And the scorners, the light in their scorning.
We just had brothers right here in front of us, dancing, quoting, acting a fool in front of their own people. They wouldn't dare do that at somebody's college or university. They wouldn't dare go and cross over to the Dollar Church and dance and call. But we get out here on this corner in the heat in front of you, brothers and sisters, to teach you what thus saith the Lord, and what do our people do? Cool, act a fool, in their simplicity. Go and read it again.
Proverbs chapter 1, verse 22. How long, ye simple ones, will ye love simplicity?
Love simplicity.
And the scorners delight in their scorning.
And that was just delighting in the scorning. Our people just delighting in the damn devil sitting right here, scorning. Scorning your own brothers. But guess what? If this was white folks here, they wouldn't allow y'all to come up here and act a fool in front of them. Y'all wouldn't dare do it in front of Master. But you would do it in front of your own brothers that look just like you. Stay in the same areas you stay in. Get treated the same way you get treated. Read.
And fools hate knowledge.
No, what did God call them? Intelligent?
And fools hate knowledge.
What did God call the black men and black women?
Fools hate knowledge.
Y'all don't want God's knowledge.
That's right.
Y'all done tried everything else and still on the bottom. Y'all tried to love the oppressor, still on the bottom.
That's right.
Tried Christianity, still on the bottom.
Trapped the Catholic Church, still in the bottom. Trapped the Marriott heathen, still in the bottom.
That's right.
Trapped the Muslim mosque, still in the bottom. Trapped Scientology, still in the bottom. Go to read again.
Proverbs chapter 1, verse 22. How long, ye simple ones, will ye love simplicity? And the scorners delight in their scorning, and fools hate knowledge.
God said, you're a fool and you hate his knowledge.
Hey.
Y'all brothers, y'all sisters don't know how to crank y'all up. It's unbelievable. I pull up a believer lie, but you bring the truth off. Man, we can't be chosen. We can't be a royal people.
The brother read the scripture where it says that fools hate knowledge. What are the fools that the Most High is talking about in the Bible? What does it talk about when it says, and fools hate knowledge? Is it talking about everybody? No, he's talking about the Israelites. We're going to prove it. Give me Isaiah chapter 1, verse 3. We're going to find out who the fools are that God is talking about. Because you're the heritage of the Most High, but you were planted a righteous, holy seed. Now you have become a degenerate plant.
That's right.
Degenerate, strange plant unto the Most High. He planted a great tree. And then he looked and he see wild weeds. Read.
Isaiah chapter 1, verse 3.
The Most High is going to tell you who the fools are that hate his knowledge, meaning his laws, his commandments, his statutes. These are the things that help get your mind right. Because if you don't have the laws of the Most High, you're dead.
That's right.
That's right.
The reason why you're in the condition that you're in. So let's find out who the fools are.
The ox knoweth his owner.
This is in the Bible. This is in the book of Isaiah chapter 1 and verse 3. Read it again.
The ox knoweth his owner.
God starts off and he says, the ox, a dumb animal like an ox, knows who his owner is.
And the ass, his master's crib.
And a jackass knows where his land is at. So what is the Most High saying? He is saying that the ox and the ass, he's giving those two dumb animals more credit than who?
But Israel doeth not know.
But the Israelites do not know who their power is. They don't know their nationality. They don't know who they are, anything. It says, but Israel don't know who they are, and they don't know where their land is at. Read the whole verse again.
Isaiah chapter 1, verse 3. The ox knoweth his owner.
The ox knows where his owner is. The ox knows who his owner is. He knows where his power is. So you can understand he knows who his God is. You so-called Negroes don't know who your God is. You call yourselves Egyptians, African Americans, Baptists,
right.
All this garbage. That ain't what the Bible's talking about at all.
That's right.
And the ass, his master's crib.
And a jackass knows where his land is at. You so-called Negroes don't know where your land is at, calling yourselves African Americans.
That's right.
Calling yourselves Nubians. Calling yourselves Egyptians. You're lost as two left shoes.
But Israel doeth not know.
But the Israelites do not know. They don't know who they are, and they don't know where their land is at. Read it again.
Isaiah chapter 1, verse 3. The ox knoweth his owner, and the ass his master's crib. But Israel doeth not know.
But the true Israelites, the true children of God, don't know that they're the children of God. That's what the Bible says about you.
My people doeth not consider.
And my people don't even care to know. That's how destroyed we are.
That's right.
Who's saying this? God in the Bible. This is in all the Bibles.
Isaiah chapter 1, verse 3. The ox knoweth his owner, and the ass his master's crib.
Two of the dumbest animals on the planet Earth knows where their power is, and they know where their homeland is.
But Israel doeth not know.
The so-called Negroes, these people on the side here, they don't know that they're the Israelites. They don't know that they're the Israelites that the Bible speaks of. So they're worse off than the ox. And they don't know that their homeland is Jerusalem. They don't know these things.
My people doeth not consider.
And my people, the Israelites, don't even care to know. So when the brother was reading about, he said that fools hate knowledge, that's the proof. That's the proof. Because the knowledge is being given to you to bring you back to your base. To bring you back to your homeland. To bring you back to the customs of your foreparents.
That's right.
And you reject that, seeing that you got some knowledge. So that when the brother read the scripture about fools hate knowledge, that's indicative of you.
Give me Psalms 94:6.
What are we out here teaching is that the black man and black woman, Hispanic man and woman, do you know you the Israelites according to the Bible? It's 2013. If you still think you're a black, African American, West Indian, Haitian, Puerto Rican, Dominican, West Indian, Cuban, Mexican, do you know you have not learned nothing? If you still have that thought in your mind, you have not learned anything.
That's right.
Because that's not who you are. You will read about an African American before 1492, before 1619. So who were you, brothers? Before that time, where do you come from? What is your customs and ways? What is your culture? What are you good at, though?
Psalms chapter 94, verse 16.
You want to read again?
Psalms chapter 94, verse 16.
Once again, we're reading out the Bible. Y'all be going to church all your life, and you ain't heard these many scriptures ever. Ever.
That's right.
Read again.
Psalms chapter 94, verse 16. Who will rise up for me against the evildoer?
What did God say to the black man, the Hispanic man?
Who will rise up for me against the evildoer?
God posed a question to you, brothers. He said, which one of y'all gonna rise up for me? And they'll rise up the gangbang, sell drugs, be a hustler, a manipulator. But who's going to rise up for me and do what?
And who will stand up for me against the workers of iniquity?
Against who?
The workers of iniquity.
Who are the workers of iniquity against us, brothers? Iniquity is sin, to make it plain to you. Who is working sin amongst our nation of people? Who got you brothers out here on the Sabbath day not keeping? Who got you brothers shaving your beards with tattoos? Bald head, sagging your pants where I can see your drawers and your butt like you're a woman. Who did this to you? Who did this to you, brothers? Got you dressed in the way of women clothes, women colors, dancing effeminate, like a woman. Who did this to you, brothers? Who did it to you? Call me again.
Psalms chapter 94, verse 16. Who will rise up for me against the evildoers?
God said, who will rise up for him? Which one of you brothers will rise up for the Most High God, read?
Or who shall stand up for me against the workers of iniquity?
Who's working iniquity in our people, man? Like I said, the things we do on the regular, we think that's good. When you read the Bible, it's totally against God. Now, I made the statement about bald heads, tattoos. Where am I getting that from? Am I BS? Am I just picking on you brothers and sisters? Or is that recorded in the Bible? Have you ever heard it before? Give me Leviticus 21 and 5 real quick. Our God command us to prove all things. I'm not going to tell you, brother, hey, you're Israelite. You shouldn't be doing this, that, and the third, and not show you when God said it. Let's go.
Leviticus chapter 21, verse 5. Thou shalt not make baldness upon their head.
Once again, thou shalt not. I know y'all thought it was only 10 commandments in the Bible, didn't you? That's all you heard on the Word Network, right? That's all you heard on TBN, right? That's only 10 commandments. Read that commandment again. Come and read it.
Leviticus chapter 21, verse 5. Thou shalt not make baldness upon their head.
So the black man, Hispanic man, the Israelite prince, you're not supposed to bald your head. That's a sin before your God. You're royalty. Royalty act a certain way, dress a certain way. Y'all didn't know that? We feel with liberty. Read again.
Leviticus chapter 21, verse 5. They shall not make baldness upon their head.
So the black man is not supposed to have a bald head. Why? Because you're Israelite, you're royalty. Royalty don't look like that. God tell you how he wants you to look. You don't have a choice in that.
That's right.
It's called a commandment. Read. Go ahead, son.
We just read out of the Bible. Bible in Psalms 94:16, and go back to Leviticus. I want both of them. Give me this Psalms first.
Psalms 94:16. Who will rise up for me against the evildoers?
This is a commandment to the men of the nation of Israel. And that's the commandment and a request from the Most High to you so-called black and Hispanic men. The Lord is asking the question. He says, who among you will rise up for me against the evildoers? What is the evil that the Most High is talking about? Sin. Which one of you men gonna be men enough to stand up to correct the sin that you see in your people?
That's right.
That's what the scriptures say. See, they've been playing in the churches with this Bible. They shouldn't have no Bible in their churches if they ain't gonna read it.
Read it again. Psalms 94:16. Who will rise up for me against the evildoers?
That's the question that God is putting out there. He says, who? Who will rise up for me against the evildoers?
That's right.
That's a question. Because how's the evil going to get rid of if you men don't fix it?
That's right.
If you men don't decide to fix it, how the hell is it going to get fixed? That's what I'm talking about. When it comes to this Bible, our people play games. They think that he's talking to the sky. He's talking to men on this earth.
That's right.
That's right.
Read it again.
Psalms 94:16.
When are you men going to get your act together and put your boots on and act like men and stand up for the Most High?
That's
and
right.
Clean up your nation. Read it.
Who will rise up for me against the evildoers?
Who is going to stand up for me against the evil that I see in my nation? That's what God is saying.
Or who will stand up for me against the workers of iniquity?
And who's going to correct the evil and the sin that I see among my people? Which one of you men going to be man enough to do that? That's what he's saying. Come on, give me the Leviticus now.
Leviticus 21:5. They shall not make baldness upon their head.
That's a commandment that God says. And God says that they shall not make baldness on their heads. That's the evil that you black men are supposed to be setting an example for our people not to do. So which one are you willing to stand up and do that? That's what he's talking about. And you've been in these churches, you've been listening to all these so-called leaders that haven't taught you nothing, and that's the reason why we are destroyed as a people.
That's right.
Because none of you have been man enough to come into the army of the Most High.
That's right.
You have not been man enough to come into the army and the militant structure of the Most High.